We do a fair bit of Colorbond replacement roofs, by which I mean we take old Colorbond off and put new Colorbond roofs on, or we do a lot of tile re-roof and replace with Colorbond roof. And I'm really biased towards Colorbond roofs because I like Colorbond roofs. I think they're a lot more functional. They are resistant to leaf blockage, resistant to hail damage, and I think they're also more thermally a better product than just a tile roof. So basis aside, I'll just go through the advantages and disadvantages, how we do a roof replacement. And in this particular case, we're looking at a tile roof being replaced by a Colorbond roof. And the main reason for this roof being replaced is that the tiles leak. And where you have a really leafy suburb, you have a lot of leaf debris on the roof. And when you have leaves on a tile roof, and if the tile roof isn't really a steep roof, you get a lot of leaks because the debris gets into the water courses, it blocks the water flow. And if you've got a big tree above your roof, then the branches fall down and then you've got holes in your roof and all that sort of stuff. So in this particular instance, they just got fed up of all these problems with the tile roof and they say, give me a better roof. And a better roof is a Colorbond roof. So we go through the process of getting tiles off. The tiles come off, they get taken to the tip. And we normally leave the old sarking on and the old tile battens on because they help stiffen the roof up. We need to put new battens on because the new Colorbond roof has to be fastened properly to sturdy battens, and the tile battens are just too skinny and we just can't screw onto the tile battens. So we put new battens on for the Colorbond roof to go on. The advantages of a Colorbond roof, I think that because we put an insulation layer under the new Colorbond roof, what we call a building blanket, it's got two purposes. One is that it's an anti-condensation layer, so you don't get any condensation under the new roof. The other thing also is because it's insulation, it insulates the metal, and you don't get a lot of heat transfer into the ceiling cavity. So therefore, it keeps your ceiling cavity, the temperature in your ceiling cavity, relatively uniform. You don't get the extreme ranges of heat like a tile roof where the tile soaks the heat and then transmits all that heat into the ceiling cavity. Whereas for a metal roof, it's insulated and you don't get a lot of heat go in. The other thing about a metal roof is that when the sun shines on it, it gets hot, but as soon as the clouds come over, the heat just dissipates and it doesn't hold the heat. Whereas tiles, they hold the heat for a long time, and then the ceiling cavity can stay really warm for a lot longer than a metal roof. Noise, some people say that the metal roofs are fairly noisy. And feedback is that once people have a metal roof on that's got a blanket insulation underneath, they can hardly tell the difference, and it kind of gives them a muffled raindrop sort of sound, which is I think more therapeutic than anything else. So I don't think noise is much of a problem with a Colorbond roof. If it's got no insulation and if it's just like you've got a tin roof with no ceilings, nothing on it, then obviously you can hear all the raindrops. But on a house roof, everything's all fairly muffled and you won't really realize that you've got a tin roof on. The critical bits, we got to do all the flashings because the flashings are the intricate bits of any roof. So that's the process of getting a roof replaced with a Colorbond roof. The major advantage of a metal roof is that it's a lot more versatile with pitches. You can have low pitch roof, you can have a varying degree of different pitches that work well together without having problems with leakage. The flashings are easier to do as opposed to a tile roof. And I'm just biased. I just like Colorbond roofs, and that's why we do so many re-roofs, replacement roofs from either tile or a existing metal roof into a Colorbond roof.